Qi and Qigong who come together to share techniques, innovative ideas and research on healing aspects of Tai Chi and Qigong and also the martial art aspect of Tai Chi and Qigong. Okay? So, in a nutshell, for those who are new and who don't know much about Tai Chi and Qigong, Tai Chi Quan or Tai Chi Chuan is a 5,000-year-old art, which is a healing art, an energy art, and not to forget that it's a martial art. But it's not like the conventional martial arts that all of us know, like karate, judo, savate, kung fu, wushu, muay thai, and all those kinds of things. It is a very subtle martial art. Many of my students, I just had one of my very good students telling me, "Sir, I cannot digest. How can you move slow and be a martial artist?" That's why the subtleness is in it. You have to understand and accept certain things. Movement, stillness, and energy. How movement works, how stillness works, and energy, and then and only then can you understand the martial art aspect. For now, Tai Chi and Qigong world around is famous because of the energy and the healing aspect of the art. Next, please. These are the benefits. Overall, if you pick up one component of Tai Chi and Qigong, these are the benefits that some people have very, very well to 100% witnessed and taken this benefit of. I'm sure all of you can read this. Next. Okay. Increasing oxygenation to your body's cell to balance blood pressure and release stress. Oxygenating your cells is a very important factor in any mode of healing, whether it's through medication, whether it's through exercise, whether it's through meditation. Tai Chi and Qigong is one of those components which can rejuvenate, heal cells and create new cells in your body. Another important aspect, calming down the nervous system to feel peaceful and composed. Very important. Not to judge any other modality of exercise, but some exercises really do not calm you but get you hyper, get you into a competitive mode. I'm not against competition, but competition should be healthy, body, mind and soul. If your competition is healthy, body, mind and soul, then only you can win. If your competition is very hyper, you cannot win. Preparing you for your daily adventures. From the time we are on this earth, it is an adventure. I'm sure all of you will agree with this. So it does prepare you for those small adventures, day in and day out. If you are into Tai Chi very deeply and you understand the working of the human mechanism and the working of the universal mechanism, you will understand how Tai Chi and Qigong or the Tai Chi and Qigong meditation prepares you for your day-to-day life. Next, please. Okay? So this is how I perceive Tai Chi and Qigong and this is how I'm going to teach it to you. It involves very ancient, just like I said, it's 5,000 years old. Ancient Tai Chi and Qigong meditations. Meditation is a very important aspect. Instead, Tai Chi is known as poetry in motion, meditation in motion, and all those kinds of things because it is a meditative art. Though you may not recognize or you may not see the person performing a Tai Chi movement, you may feel that that person is not meditating, but in actuality, the practitioner is completely in a meditation mode. Mystical movements known by a chosen few. This sentence is over there because in my life of learning Tai Chi, I have learned Tai Chi and Qigong from confirmed masters. When I say confirmed masters, masters who have a name, who are known around the world, and also those masters whose names we are not supposed to disclose, or those masters who would not like themselves to be known as masters. Now these unknown teachers have really taught us very, very mystical moves, simple moves. And those who are very familiar with my teaching, you all must have seen very simple and very mystical moves. Like we do the Tai Chi clap, I showed you how to heal your heart by doing three sets of 9-9 claps. These are all mystical moves. I'm sure if you see somebody keep on clapping, you may say, this guy has gone mad, why the hell is he clapping? Now those moves are very mystical because you don't understand it. And we have done many other mystical moves. These mystical moves comes from mystical masters. Masters who have spent years and years together in the caves, practicing and perfecting the art. So that's why mystical and known really by a very chosen few of people. Okay? And practice which leads one to greater levels of spirituality. Yes, Tai Chi is also a spiritual art, which we intend, the power of intending, that is mind energy and sound energy. One component of sound energy is chanting. We all have chanted Buddhist chants, our Indian chants. We have chanted Shiva's chants, we have chanted Lakshmi chants and many different chants. What I will teach you today is those mystical chants which I have learned from those unknown masters or masters who would not like to be known as masters. So these are the components of Qigong meditation. Next please. The first sound, the first chant. Right up here, ha, wa, hun. Now these chants which I am going to show you, this sound vibrations which I am going to show you, as you see on the slide, each word sends the energy and vibration to a particular organ or part of your body. Now as you see, ha, wa, hun, ha is the energy for the heart to vibrate the heart. Va vibrates the brain or it's the head energy. And hun, the stomach energy or energy of the digestive system. Okay? Heart energy, our energy needs heart. Our heart needs energy for one very simple reason. We all have something which is called a small heart. After doctors say that you should not have a big heart, you are in trouble if you have a big heart. But when we come to Tai Chi and Qigong, we have to have a big heart. Okay? A closed heart or a small heart is when we sit at judging people and getting emotions of judgment into us. Why did that person say so much? I don't like that person. That person does not like me. Lovely loves me, blah 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 blah, makes your heart shrink. Vaha, brain or head. We all know this brain of ours, how fast it works. Okay? A small dot, a small black dot on a white wall. The moment your brain perceives it, it can get thousands and thousands of names. Somebody must have just touched that white wall with a dirty finger. But I will say it's a rising moon. You will say it's the setting sun. Somebody else will say somebody has spat paan on it. Somebody will say it's a bindi. It's a big forehead and it's a bindi there. Somebody will say it's Shiva's third eye. So we all know how the brain works. And today because of the energy of you and my brain, most of you sitting may be fantastic, great professionals in their own field. So brain energy again very important. And then hun, the stomach energy, very important energy. Stomach can store those negative emotions which you and I don't need. Stomach can bring in those negative emotions which you and I don't need. Have we all heard of butterflies in the stomach? Why butterflies in the stomach? Why not butterfly in my head? Why not butterflies in my heart? Okay, because the negative emotion of nervousness is stored with the digestive system. Or nervousness has everything to be done with the digestive system. whenever you are in trouble, whenever you are stressed, your whole digestive system or the stomach goes haywire, upset. So the energy of the stomach is very important. There are different ways of pronunciation. Ha, va, hun. You can chant it fast, you can chant it slow, you can chant it singing. Before we go on to the next chant, we will try out this chant. Okay? Now, as we have suggested on this slide, ha is the vibration for the heart energy. So I would like all of you to put your palm, the chest, or wherever you feel your heart is. If it is here, please put your hand here also. Okay? So wherever your heart is, and I hope we won't be disturbing anybody now. No, surely we are not disturbing anyone. Will we be disturbing you, ma'am? Sure? No? Thank you. Okay? Now let me give you a secret. If you chant slowly, small cells in your body will vibrate. If you chant loudly, large cells in your body will vibrate. What are the large cells? Your heart, your lungs, your spleen, your pancreas, your gallbladder, the lymph nodes, they are large cells. So if you chant loudly, large cells vibrate. Large cells are as important as the smaller cells. Okay? Now take this tip from me. So you, I'm sure, know what I mean. Okay? Now let your ha come out from the pit of your stomach. Do it with some commitment. Okay? Don't ha. What is this guy thinking of me? Or what is that guy thinking of me? Please don't do that. Be with yourself. Enjoy. Enjoy. I have asked madam. Ma'am says she's not going to be disturbed. There is nobody down reading a book also. So we are free to do this chanting. Okay? Now have the hand there. On exhalation, ha, long, elongated as you feel, short if you want to, and feel whether this part vibrates or not, because you have to feel a connection. Okay? Are we ready? So hands, palms on the heart, inhale according to you. Whenever you want to start exhaling, ha. Ha. Relax for a bit. Once again, inhale. And on exhalation, once again. Feel your the vibration is moving to your heart. Relax, hands down. Can we feel the vibration in the heart? All of us? Sure, all of us have heart. That's so good to know that. Okay? Now the next one, the va. It's va or va. Okay? Va is also okay. So what we do is, we have our palms placed somewhere on our head. And on exhalation, again a va, and we feel whether we can feel the vibration. So you could touch here, you could touch here, you could touch here. Feel the vibration, because it will move to certain parts of the brain. For some reason, certain parts of our brain will not vibrate. Okay, don't worry, it's not a big ailment. Okay, it's just because of certain emotional blocks, certain part you will not feel the vibration because of that part of the brain hardening a little. Okay, when I say hardening, not physical hardening, but energy hardening. Okay, so hold, inhale very normally, no forceful breathing. Whenever you are ready, exhaling and produce the sound. Just relax for a bit. Once again. Hands down, please. Can we get the vibration up to the brain? How many could do that? Let's have a show of hands moving up. Fantastic, fantastic. We have all our energy channels open, that means. Very good. Hun. Okay? Now for hun, we will do it faster. Okay, so we'll have our palms placed on the lower ab and also a little above the navel, and we'll repeat it a little fast, okay, so you can feel. Don't try on purpose to move your tummy. Just produce the word from the pit of the stomach and see whether there is movement in your whole tummy, that is the intestine including the stomach. Okay, watch me doing it. Hun, 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 hun. Feel the vibration. Hun, 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 hun. Relax. Vibration in the tummy, very good. Okay, I'm sure all of you know, those who are medical students, the setup inside, the two organs are close to each other, they're very fine hair like fibers in between them, okay, which is called the fascia. I hope I'm pronouncing it right. Now, sometimes it is seen in energy work when these fascias between these two organs harden for certain reasons. Wrong food, wrong emotion, wrong movements. When they harden, they break. When they break, the organs clash with each other. They stick to each other. And I'm sure you know, when two things are completely stuck to each other, there is no oxygen passing through it. And that thing can start to rot. Okay, and that can give you things like cancer. That can give you things like ailment. Now, when you produce, so when you chant these sounds, they literally move to the small fibers, vibrating those fibers, and in return this vibration moves also out to the organs, vibrating those large organs. So the organs are flexible. If the organs are flexible, they can function properly, they can function to the maximum level that you and I needed to function. Okay, so there are two ways of chanting. One very simple way: if you want calm energy, sit with your eyes closed. You can sit on a chair, you can stand and do it. Please don't lie down and do it. You can sit in Vajrasana, you can sit in Padmasana, Arth Padmasana, whatever you feel like, and then you can chant very slowly. Avahun, 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 avahun. Remain silent with your eyes closed for some time. Okay, very slowly open your eyes. Can anybody share, while we were chanting, what do you feel? Anybody? Anybody? Anybody share whatever. If you don't feel anything, it's okay. Absolute fine to say no. Pardon? Vibration up in the head. Yes, anybody else? Full body sensation. Very good. Yes. Pardon? Your body is light. Okay. So this is one way to bring calmness. There is still one more thing I am searching for. Okay. There is still one more thing I am still searching for in the meditation that we are. Yes, sir. Energy moving. Yes. Energy moving in your body. Yes, that's what I am searching for, because I am teaching you where energy are. Okay, so the vibrations that you felt in your whole body is the energy moving in your whole body. Okay, or the energy of vibration, you may call it. You may call it energy of your cells. You may call it energy of your own body. To go on a spiritual level, you may call it the energy of the universe which has gone into your body. Okay, now this is one way to bring calmness, to bring a little happiness and all those kinds of things happening. Now, if you want strength and if you want to get out anger, okay, we are all suffering from this disease called anger and aggression, all of us, including me. I am no saint. Okay, so this is how you will get it out. Now, all meditations you must have learned: close your eyes, hold a mudra, dim lights, beautiful music, no. Now I'm going to ask you, don't hold your eyes, clench your fist as tight as you can. Keep your eyes open. Stare, and if you want, stare at me. Okay? Visualize in me the worst enemy or the person you are most angry with. Fine? Eyes as wide as you can. And the pace moves fast. Ha wa hun, 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 ha wa hun,
ha wa hun.
Now anybody can share with me what happened. Okay, nobody to share? What happened? Nobody had anger? Yes?
Energy increases.
Energy increases. Okay, you will not lose anything. But you will bring in an energy which will harmonize with your energy of anger. Remember one thing. Stress and energy of anger cannot be removed out of your system. These two things are needed in life. You can get into competition, which I don't advise, but because we all have responsibilities of families, of earning, of getting a day-to-day food, you have to have competition. You have to compete with other people. And that can happen, you can have good competition only when you are stressed about doing something. If you are a laid back person, jaande yaar dekh lega, it will not work. You have to fight for it. Now when can you get stressed? Is when somebody or your partner is there doing very well in the very same multinational company on the very same post. And time and again, time and again, time and again is pulling your leg under the table and not letting you move forward with a promotion. And you know it very well. So you have these two components, stress and anger. This stress and anger will make you work more harder. Okay? And this goes for everybody and everything. So you really can't remove it. What you have to do by chanting Hava Hun at this pace, you are strengthening your body. The stress and anger does not affect you physically, mentally and spiritually. But your soul, your mind and your body is ready to carry this energy of fire. Are we right? Everybody agrees to this? Very good. Okay, so two ways, very slowly, you can go more slower. You can sing it. Ah-wah-hum. Awahun, awahun, awahun. Or you can go faster. Awahun, awahun, awahun. Or still faster like we did for anger. Awahun, 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 awahun. Okay? This goes for all the chants that I'm going to teach you now. Okay? Let's have. You can do it from anywhere from 2 minutes to 5 minutes. Okay? Yes, and I know very well, sometimes when we are in our homes, we cannot chant loud. Okay? Those are the times you may chant slowly. Okay? Otherwise, if you have some place where you can chant loud, not even as loud as this, but yes, you should know that you are chanting. Other people should hear that, okay, kuch tabhi badbad kar raha hai. Okay? So, it should be heard. Okay? It should go out into the universe. Because these will move out. This energy, this positive sounds will move out into the universe, and all of us know like attracts like. So when these sound vibrations move out, they bring the same sound vibrations back again to you. Right? Can we have the next slide, please?
Sir, what is the best time to do this? Going back to bed?
See, many traditions in our country, many traditions in the Chinese country, in Thailand, and many of these places, these Asian places, spirituality is on a very high ebb. we all have different, you know, like we all know in our Indian tradition, the Brahma Muhurt, beautiful time, everybody says, 3:30 to 6:30. Then in China, it is sometime more late, from 1:30 late into the morning, that is the night I'm talking about, from 1:30 to 4:30. So, by, you know, analyzing all these timings of these different countries and different traditions, I came to a conclusion. The best time is when you chant and when you do it. Isn't it? Okay? Okay. We have the next chant. Vung Ar Hong. Vung Ar Hong. Okay. Once again, Vung is to the head. And while you chant, you visualize your whole head internally and externally lit up with a red light. R is the chest, this whole chest area right up to the waist joint, which you visualize in a white light. Hong is the abdomen, which you visualize, that is below the waist joint, in a blue light. So here again we are using the energy, okay, the energy of sound, that is chanting, and we are also using mind energy, that is visualizing, and again we are using color energy by inducing the color into those particular parts of our body. Okay, this meditation is a slight different from the other, again done on exhalation, but all the three words are to be chanted on one exhalation. Right? So I will inhale. And the moment I'm exhaling, I'm going to produce the sound. Vung-a-rong. Only on exhalation. Vung-a-rong. Okay? Now you could do this. Remember, have the visualizing, very important. This is how this chant is different from the other chant. The first chant, we are not visualizing. We are using the sense of feeling. We are bringing a feeling. Here, we are moving up more to our mind, where we are going to visualize. Intent, very important. If your intention is strong, you are strong. If intention is not strong, I don't know. No, just visualize the light in that area of your body. Imaginary. Yes, just visualize, yes, just visualize. Feel the whole head red color. Feel the whole chest white color. Feel the whole lower abdomen blue color. Okay, that much. Fine? So, this is how it will happen. Here, let's do a little active energy. Okay? Let's do a little active energy, which we will have, or rather feel a ball of energy in our palms. So I would like, given the sitting pose, to halt, to have your right palm a little above your navel, your left palm below the navel, as if you are holding a ball of energy. You can rest your arms on the chair, but have the palms facing each other, and on exhalation only you will chant the three words Vung Ar Hong. Now what I want you to do is, all of you, I am sure you cannot breathe in harmony with each other. So it's not going to be one voice. Okay, there will be a voice from here, there will be a voice from here, there will be a voice from there, there will be there. So chant at your own pace. Chant at your own pace. Don't wait for your partner to chant with you. It will not happen. Because the pace of my breathing is not the same pace that this gentleman will have or this madam is going to have. We are all breathing at a different pace. I want to be with your pace, be with you to experience really what happens. If you are going to say, okay boss, I am feeling a little awkward, preferably I will say chant in the mind. Because only if you do it, you are really going to get the crux, the essence and the spirit of what the chant is going to mean to you. Okay, am I fine? If you feel you don't want to chant very loud, don't chant very loud. But again remember, the funda is, you chant loudly, large cells vibrate, you chant slowly, or in your mind, small cell vibrates. We want the large cells to vibrate. Okay? So this, eyes closed, relax. And on exhalation. Breathe normal breathing. Don't do this. It will not happen. Have your mind on your breathing. Remember, it's a meditation. Have your mind on your breathing. You are inhaling normally. It takes you, I think, so a normal person 6 seconds to inhale, 6 seconds to exhale, or sometimes lesser for some people who have problems, and more for people who practice a lot of pranayama and breathing. So according to your pace, do that. And on exhalation, chant all the three words, Vang, Ar, Hong, with the visualizing. It's very important. Okay? You may start. Don't wait for the partner. Whenever you feel like, be free to chant on exhalation. Keep your palms together for some time. Stop chanting. Keep your palms together very lightly. Just let your palms touch each other. Concentrate between both your palms. Just visualize, just feel what is happening between both your palms. Okay, you may open your eyes. Very good. Anybody would like to share something about this chanting? Whole body is vibrating. Very good. Whole body is vibrating. Fantastic. Anybody else? Pardon, sir? Very good. Very good.
This chanting and visualizing doesn't
sometimes doesn't synchronize. Yeah, initially stages, it will synchronize. See, it's a meditation, so you need to concentrate a little more when you do it. Okay, it will happen. At beginning stages, it's rather difficult because you're trying to understand the word and the sound. Your mind is more on the sound and the word. Okay? So, okay, not a problem.
Then if we reduce the rate, if there is a gap between the two words, it's okay.
It's okay, it's okay. Yeah. But preferably try to do all the three words together. Okay? That's very important. Yes? Then in the lower arm. Okay. Good, good. Very nice. Okay.
Mind travels with color and sound.
Pardon, sir?
Mind travels with the color and sound simultaneously.
Yes, yes. See, in Qigong, we very firmly believe where the mind goes, energy goes. Okay, that's why I always advise people. Many of my motivation talks, I always tell people, what you want? What I want, I have diabetes, I don't want to have diabetes. So what do you do? I chant every day. What do you chant every day? I chant every day, my diabetes is cured, my diabetes is cured, my diabetes is cured. Will it cure?
No.
No. Why? Where was your mind? My diabetes, my diabetes, my diabetes. No. Why not chant, I am healthy, I am healthy, I am healthy. Okay? See, that's why sometimes beautiful alternative therapies don't work. Or rather, the practitioners feel it does not work. The greatest alternative therapy that you and I have is the power of your mind, the power of your intent. There is no energy. There is no energy in this universe which equals the power of your intent and the mind. If you know how to phrase certain affirmations, and if you know how, in a very relaxed manner to ask. Usually how we ask, and sorry to say, I see many of you chanting also in that way. You know, you say, I should be healed, I should be healed, my leg pain should go, my leg pain should go. This will not work. If you are going to stiffen, tighten your body, harden your mind, energy will not pass through. Very simple example, a water pipe connected to a tap and you're filling another vessel. If you are going to hold that pipe and twist it, will the water flow? The same happens in your body. If the meridians are tightened, if the meridians are stiff, meridians are energy paths. If they are stiff, energy will not travel. When you want to receive energy in any modality, you have to be relaxed. And you have to have that intent of, it is going to happen. Or rather, I have been there, I know it. Remember this, always. I have been there, I know it. So, if you have an ailment, your mind should focus on the healing. I have been there, I was healed, I know I am going to be healed. Okay? Not I have diabetes and now I am going to be healed of diabetes. It's not going to work. Okay? Now, let me tell you, this is one of the most powerful chanting and healing chants. Okay? All modalities today are adopting this chant. You name it, the greatest, the biggest teachers. The very latest teacher that I can talk to you about, who from even I have learned quite a lot, is Dr. and Master Qigong Shah, who is here in India every year, I suppose, year and all that. I've not been to him for 4 years now, but before that, when he first came to India, I learned a lot from him. And he's a very firm believer in Vangar Hang. Okay? And we also, who we have given this chance to people to chant, have come back and gave us very good testimonies. People have been healed from all kinds of pains, ailments. And not only about physical and body ailments in your day-to-day life. Improvement in your business, improvement in your work, improvement in your studies. So it can do such a lot of things. The thing is, try it out. Try to do it. You cannot spend 5 minutes, spend 2 minutes every day. Okay? This is one chant which you can also do lying down. Okay? So you can even lie down and you can still chant. But it's about keeping an appointment. Let me make this thing very clear with you. See, it's about keeping an appointment. We have all kept appointments. Or let me say, a date. When I was dating my wife over here, and she would call me up, okay boss, I'm bunking 2 lectures, see that you are there. So class, bus, everything cancel, I'm going to meet my DM. No way I would cancel that appointment. Now why I'm telling you this? We all identify with certain appointments at our workplace. None of us want to miss our exams. If I have an exam, I still remember going 2 hours before and to the center. The same way your meditation should be. Never miss your appointment with your meditation. If you are meditating, yes, again, like I said, the best time is the time that you can practice. But in this 24 hours life cycle of ours, you have to keep your appointment with meditation. You miss it out and you miss a breath. You miss a breath and you miss this much of good health. Start to calculate it. Very simple. Okay? So never miss this appointment of exercising. Never miss the appointment of meditating. Never miss this appointment with God. Let me come to the spiritual part. Never miss this appointment with the creator that you believe in. Whoever, whatever. Energy, light, God, Allah, whatever you can call upon. Never miss these appointments. These are the appointments which will keep you and me going. Which will keep you and me in harmony with all that happens in the universe. Okay, can we have the next one, please? A 6-word chant. Again, a very, very famous chant. originated in Tibet. Okay, today it's famous all around the world. And many people have their own versions of explaining this to you. I would advise you, don't try to go and postmortem everything. Don't try to analyze. Was it Tibet? Is it Chinese? Is it Indian? Are the words that way? No. What you see is the energy that is going to be produced when you chant it. Have your awareness on the energy the moment you see the slide and you read the headline. Okay, Wung, Ma, Ni, Ba, Ma, Hong. What does it feel? How it responds to you? That is more important than, you know, typecasting it. Okay, it's from Tibet, then it went maybe to China, then it went to Japan, then it went to Vietnam, now it has come back to us. Don't go into all this. Don't waste your time, my dear people. Don't waste your time. We have wasted enough of time under the name of research. You will give a different version of your research. I will give a different version of my research. You will say, I am wrong. I will say, you are wrong. There will be lots of fights, lots of arguments. You are deprived of wonderful energy. Does it bother? Does it bother you, I mean, whether it is black or it's white? It does not. If you are a black man and you are a white country, then you will know. And if you are a white man in a black country, then again you will know. And if you are an Indian in a foreign country, then you will know the importance of energy. Then you will tell people, "Arey, what if I'm an Indian and I'm here in the United States of America? I'm a human being." Then you are a human being. When the white man is in the black country, he will tell the black people, "So what if I'm white? I'm a human being." So why then come and get into the nitty-gritty of trying to dissect pura wunga wrong and see from where it comes and how it is? And this goes not only for this chant, this also goes for life. This also goes for life. Yes, do research, healthy research. And when you feel there is a controversy arising, when you feel there is an argument, when you feel people are going against people and the essence of what you have started is being lost, stop that research, it is useless. Do you know why cancer is not being cured today? Do you know why AIDS is not going cured today? Do you know that? For the same reason, I say have a cure for cancer. I have to put up my case to 20 different countries. Medical association of blah, blah, blah. Scientist association of blah, blah, blah. I am one person getting my research papers to you. 20 people start to point fingers and oppose me. How, why, where, does it, does not. In the end, what happens? Either I get a heart attack, I'm fully stressed, I pop off, or I get fed up, take the papers and throw it away, or I'll keep giving papers till I'm 90 or 100 years old and I pop off. What happens? I must have had a cure for cancer. Who is responsible, my dear people? Who is responsible? So don't go to dissect everything. If you dissect everything, remember, you lose the energy. We have lost many cures to cancer. We have lost many cures to AIDS. We have lost many cures to chikungunya. We have lost many cures to hepatitis for one same reason. Lot of questions, lots and opposing people. So this doesn't work. And I'm telling you this is because don't try to, you know, go on the net again. Yes, do go on the net. But अरे सर ने तो बोला ये तिब्बत है लेकिन यह तो चाइनीज है. माय नेक्स्ट वर्कशॉप यू विल कम एंड क्वेश्चन मी, सर मैंने तो देखा था इट वाज चाइनीज, हाउ यू सेड इट वाज तिब्बत. डोंट गो इनटू दैट. सी द एनर्जी दैट इज गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस एंड सी व्हाट द एनर्जी कैन डू फॉर यू, दैट इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट. ओके, सो वंग मा नी बा मा होंग. ओके, अगेन you can chant it at different paces. You can chant it at a very beautiful pace. There's Dr. Qigong Shadas. Vung mani ba ma hung, 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 Vang 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 mani ba ma hung. Okay? Use a tune which will vibrate to you. You may again go close, slower. Vang mani ba ma hung. Vang mani ba ma hung. Vang mani ba ma hung. Vang mani ba ma Vang mani ba ma hung, 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 vang mani ba ma hung. Okay, different paces. Choose, see what vibrates with you, see how you feel, and when you chant, also have an awareness. What is happening inside your body? Like, okay, you see the first word brings healing and vibration or energy to the eyes, to the ears, nose, cures all kind of headaches and problems in the head. Okay, so when we say problem in the head, please don't wait for serious problems. Sinus, if you have head pain in sinus, chant vung 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 vung, you will feel the vibration. Okay, so don't wait for some very serious head problems. Okay, ma and ni, okay, goes to the throat, shoulders, elbows, heart and lungs. Okay, again I will repeat, don't wait for serious problems. Okay, slight pain in the shoulder, try it out. Mani, 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 mani. Okay? So what we will do now? We are all conversed with Vang. Okay? We have done Vungar Hong by placing our palms on the head. So we know it vibrates. Okay? Can we have the next one, please? The one before this, the previous one. Okay, so let's try ma ni, throat, shoulders, elbows, hearts and lungs. So let's have a palm maybe a little while on the throat, a little while on the shoulder, a little while on the elbows. We are convinced with the heart and lungs also with R. Okay, but even also let's try ma and ni. So as we chant, we'll try to move our arms. So maybe a few chants here, a few chants here, a few chants. Okay, are we ready? Okay, so where are we doing? What are we starting? With the throat. So let's have throat. Have your palm very lightly placed. You don't have to press. I see the movement. There will be a pulsing, a vibration. Okay? Start. Ma ni, 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 ma. Let's try shoulders. Ma ni, 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 ma elbows, ma ni, Mani, 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 Heart, Mani, 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 Lungs, Mani, 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 relax. Okay, are we convinced? Is it going? Can you feel the vibrations? Very good, beautiful. Can we have the next slide, please? Okay, Vung Ma Ni Ba Ma. Okay, so Ba and the Ma moves to the spine, back, kidneys, stomach, intestine. Okay, so let's try the spine. You could have your palm lightly pressed on the spine. We'll also try the kidneys, which are above the waist joint, as we chant a little while on the stomach. Okay, very light, don't press. If you cannot do this, if you find you're tensing your body, don't do this, because you're doing it for the first time. If you tense your body, you will not feel the vibration. Remember what I told you about energy. Relax. If you relax, energy flows. Right? So let's see for the spine. Okay, just lightly place your hand. Are we ready? Ba ma, 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 kidneys, ba ma, 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 stomach, ba ma, 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 intestine, ba ma, 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 relax. Are we convinced? Movement, there is movement, there is vibrations. Very good. Okay, the last, the six words, hung. Hung goes to legs and the best joints of all the body. People suffering from arthritis, stiff joints. Amazing, we have amazing results with this one beautiful word. Okay, so let's try it. You can place your palms on your laps, maybe on your knees, very lightly. Okay, are we ready? Good. Hung, 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 relax. How many good? This is a tough one. How many could feel the vibration? You could? Very good. Very fine. Okay. So it's not only the joints, because it's comfortable for us to place hand on the knee. It is for the joints of all the body. Remember, stiffness, especially in this winter season, people with arthritis, maybe a fracture here and there, dislocations, these all, you know, start to trouble you in winter. They say so. I don't know. Okay. I don't know what to say, whether to believe it or not to believe it. But let's say, try it out. Okay. you don't need to put your palm. You just go into a meditation. Okay? Can we go back to the first slide? So before we leave, we'll just do a little 2 minute meditation of all this. So once again, really meditatively, we will try it out. Okay? Okay? Can we go to Havahum? No need. Only Vungar Hong and Hava Hun have to be done. But for people who are having heart problems, people who suffer from breathlessness, you do not focus on the breathing, on exhalation, you can just keep chanting it. Okay, instead, these are those chants where you can go every day, you know, even while you are walking. Hava Hun in your mind. Okay, it works like I said. Chant in your mind, small cells vibrate, we need that. Chant loudly, the larger cells vibrate, we also need that. Okay, so really now focusing, you know where it is. Ha to the heart, Va to the brain or the head energy, Hun to the stomach. Okay, so let's sit up straight. Keep your feet flat down to the earth. Okay. So keep your eyes closed and we will chant not very loudly and not very slowly and we will see what happens. So for this we will not focus on the breathing, we will do it without a breathing, so also you will get, you know, just the zest of only chanting how it is. We'll chant in our mind and when I say silence, we'll chant a little loud. When I say silence, you just keep chanting in your mind, okay, till I ask you to rub your palms. Warm up your palms and place it on your eyes. And then we will open our eyes. Okay, please not open your eyes completely if you are going to keep your eyes closed in a meditation. Always remember, it's advisable to always warm the eyelids, separate the fingers, see through the fingers, bringing your palms down. So are we ready? Palms on the lap. And we are going to chant at a medium pace. And when I say silent, you are going to chant in your mind. So let's chant. Ha, Va, Hun. Ha Va Hun, 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 Ha Va Hun. Ha Va Hun, 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 Ha Va Hun. Silent, repeat in your mind.